والصلاه والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا اشرف الانبياء والمرسلين رحمه للعالمين خاتم النبيين شفيع المذنبين ابي القاسم محمد اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد والصلاه والسلام على اهله وعلى بيته الطيبين الطاهرين كما قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم وهو اصدق القائلين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم انما يريد الله ليذهب عنكم رجس اهل البيت ويطهركم تطهيرا اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد اما بعد ربي اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقده من لساني يفقهوا قولي امين يا رب العالمين all the praise and all the glory belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala we are continuing with our so we are going to be discussing Surah Al-Kawthar. So no one has been able to challenge it, and in his days remained pristine exactly as was revealed until now. There's the Quran. You see, we are speaking about the Quran and whatever has been revealed in it. Nobody's able to challenge it. It has remained pristine exactly as was revealed until now. Quran is proven, and your others of the different communities, tried to find any faults in the Quran and they could not. And this truly is, Quran is truly in the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, pristine and changed exactly as it was revealed. So what we read and recite in the Quran is exactly the same that was read and recited by Rasulullah. This is a wonderful feeling, when you get that feeling that these are the same words, nothing has been changed, the same words that was said by Rasulullah, by all the Imams, Imam al-Tawlis, when they were giving the khutbah, when they were quoting words exactly the same. There's no difference. So this, that feeling itself, to have that feeling that's totally pristine, totally untainted, totally unchanged, there's no tahrif at all, not even the kafata or the kasra or the dhamma, exactly as it is. This is a wonderful feeling. So what we read and recite then is exactly the same that was read and recited by Rasulullah himself, all of the masumeen, a'imma alayhi salam, until today, we said exactly the same words. This will be, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises that it is He who is going to protect us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals in the Quran that it is we who revealed it, it is us who are going to protect it. So this protection is guaranteed. This is the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, untainted, unchanged, the fatah, the kathra, the dhamma, everything remains the same, pristine. And this is a wonderful feeling to have when we hold the Quran. As a matter of fact, there's a beautiful hadith that, when we are actually holding the Quran, we have a direct connection straight with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is really wonderful to have that feeling when you're just holding the, you see, that is why, and I'm actually thinking now, that on the nights of the Amal, when we have, we are told, just open the Quran and just hold it. Why? Because there's a direct connection. We get a direct connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is quite, amazing. So, so the Quran will be protected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is promised, it is His promise, in His words, in the Quran itself, in Surah Al-Hijr, which is Surah number 15, ayat number 9, inna nahnu nazzalna dhikra wa inna lahu lahafizun. That we have, when we have in Arabic, in the Quran, when you have inna, it means that definitely, without any doubt. Inna, without any doubt. Nahnu as nazzalna dhikra. It is us who have revealed this dhikr. The Quran is called the dhikr, and the name of the Quran is dhikr. Inna nahnu nazzalna dhikra wa inna lahu lahafidhun. It is up to us to give it a complete, total protection. So this is a guarantee of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself, and as we mentioned, pristine, not corrupted in any way from the time it was revealed until now. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Now what happens here? Okay. So, you know, Yeah, so you know, we ask, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us, you know, through the Quran and the true and preserved Sunnah of Rasulullah is taught to us by the Masumeen alayhi salam, a'imma of the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us, you know, the great gift He reveals about it in the Quran. It is the hikmat, you know, the wisdom. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells, you know, look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals. Wisdom is a great gift. You know, anyone you see, a person may not have gone to universities and been, you know, total graduate, all that, but he doesn't have the hikmat. If he doesn't have the wisdom, as opposed to someone who might not have gone to the university to get big degrees or anybody, he or she has got hikmat. That hikmat itself is the greatest gift, better gift than any PhD who has got no hikmat at all. So, you know, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals us in the Quran, you know, where he says, yutil hikmat man yashau, وَمَنْ يُوتَ الْحِكْمَةَ فَقَدْ أُوتِيَ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا يَذَكَّرُ إِلَّا أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that Allah grants wisdom to whom He pleases, and he to whom wisdom is granted has received indeed a benefit overflowing, but none will understand, none will grasp the message except men of understanding. So you see that it is, you know, so even in our, you know, families as well, you know, if you see a member in our family who has hikmat, wisdom, that wisdom can, you know, alleviate many problems and can solve many things and, you know, shows the right path of, you know, success to the whole family. So hikmat is the most important, the greatest gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives. So, you know, now, so I'm sure, you know, the most of you already know that, you know, Surah Al-Kawthar is one of the three shortest surahs in the Quran. The two shortest surahs in the Quran are, you know, Surah Al-Asr, right? Well, Asr, Ibn Insan, Nafi Khusr, Lilladin Aman, Wamil Salihat, Watawa Sobi Haki, Watawa Sobi Sabr. And then the other is Surah Al-Nas. And then this one here. So these are the three shortest surahs, because they contain only three ayat. So these three surahs contain only three ayat. These are the shortest surahs in the Quran. So today we are looking at Surah Al-Kawthar. And Surah Al-Kawthar, you know, is revealed as follows. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Inna a'tainaka. This is referring to Rasulullah, to you, without any doubt. Inna a'tainaka al-Kawthar. Fasalli li rabbika wanhar. Inna shaniyaka huwal abtar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells Rasulullah that, you know, we have surely given you in abundance something that's uncountable. The mercies and the blessings are uncountable. Inna atainaka al-kawthar. Fasalli li rabbika wanhar. Pray therefore to your Rabb and offer your sacrifice. Inna shaniyaka huwal abtar. You know, the Meccans, you know, the Quraysh, were actually taunting Rasulullah, you know, that he doesn't have any sons, he doesn't have any children, he had a daughter, but there were no sons. You know, sometimes, you know, this was very painful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells Rasulullah, don't worry, because, you know, you in shaniyaka huwal abtar. Surely he who hates you, he is the one who shall be cut off. So, you know, so it's beautiful that, you know, that you will be given al-kawthar, abundance. You have got abundance, O Rasul. Bismillah, inna a'tainaka al-kawthar. We have surely given you in abundance. Fasalli rabbika wanhar, therefore pray to your Rabb and offer your sacrifice, surely without any doubt. He who hates you, those who tell you that, you know, he has got no sons, you know, they are the ones who are going to be cut off, not you. And it's quite amazing. So what will we learn, specifically learn from this surah, you know, Surah Al-Kawthar? What are we going to learn? We will learn three important prophecies that will fulfill exactly as revealed. The first prophecy was Kawthar. Kawthar means abundance. Kathir Kawthar, abundant, given to Rasulullah, was fulfilled to its fullest. And all the prophecies given to him, as for example, Islam was established, he had all the victories, the Mecca was conquered, the Kaaba was cleansed of all the idols, with all the idols and many things prophesied, including that he is the real seal of the prophets, Khatamun Nabiyyin. All this revelation that seemed to be impossible. How can it happen? But Allah promised, and everything happens. All this, in spite of the fact that none of this could have been predictable in Mecca, even before the Hijrah. It's quite unique, if you really think about it. So then, the surah is, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar, O Rasul, surely, see, Inna means Allah promises. Surely, surely, we have a'tainaka, we have atakiya, humne aapko atakiya hai, we have given you, without any doubt, al-kawthar, in abundance. All the good we have given you. Inna atinaga al-kawthar. Then I say in Gujarati as well, so the meaning of the word al-kawthar is the meaning of kathrat. And as Mufassir tells, it means, that some kawthar is a descriptive case derived from kathrat, with the meaning of abundance. And in Gujarati, ku pramarma apuche tamne. So the Gujarati translation of the first ayat is, Ay Rasul, chokas ame tamne, pushkar pramarma apuche. We've given you in abundance, oh the prophet. So, and commentaries also show that the revealed word, kawthar, in this surah refers to the abundance of the progeny of Rasulullah through Bibi Fatima the Zahra. Assalamu alayhi. Can we want salawat, please? Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ali. Can we want loud salawat, please? Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ali Muhammad. They will be given you through Bibi Fatima the Zahra. Assalamu alayhi. And they will continuously multiply, and will be so many, and there will be so many that it will be impossible even to count to them. At the time, Rasulullah did not have any progeny. People were, telling his abtar, childless, sonless, his abtar. They were calling him abtar of Safullah Betul. And Allah well promised, no. You will live in abundance. And today, if you see, from the other Rasul, how many other Rasul, you cannot even count them. It's quite amazing. In my own experiences, traveling in the month of Muharram, especially in one particular year, I was really surprised to meet someone from the Sayyid who came from a remote town, very remote town of USA. I had gone to Seattle, and from far away from the villages there, I saw this man, he was a Sayyid, to attend the Muharram Majalis. So in my search for this tafsir, I came across an amazing quotation from a respected and reliable Sunni source who says this. He says that, and I quote.
And it shows in the quote there, right?
Yeah, it shows you. The third statement is that this surah has been revealed to reject those who criticize the Rasulullah for his lack of progeny, for the lack of, children. Therefore, the meaning of the surah is that Allah shall give him a generation which will remain stable through all the ages. It has remained through all the ages until now, and it will remain. It is a promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, and also, consider this, that although a number of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam have been martyred, the world is replete with them, whereas from the Umayyads, who were the enemies of Islam, there remains no memorable figure in the world. Then behold and see how many of the great men of leadership, such as, Imam al-Baqir al-Islam, Jafar Sadiq al-Islam, Imam Raza al-Islam, and all the Imams, and Nafs al-Zakiyah are found among them in the household of your Rasulullah. This is absolutely unique. Can we want salawat, please? Musalli ala Muhammadin wa ala Muhammad. Now, we are told in our sources, if we are told in sources like Majmal Bayan and other sources as well, that when Rasulullah recited this surah from the minbar, some companions asked him the meaning of Kawthar. So when Rasulullah was reciting from the mimbar, inna atainaka al-kawthar, some, you know, from the companions who were sitting, you know, and you know, they could ask him quite openly there, you know, Ya Rasulullah, what is the meaning of this? So, you know, and he replied, Rasulullah actually replied by telling them that it is a stream in the heaven, in the Jannat. It is a stream. It is whiter than milk, more clear than a goblet of crystal with dome-shaped ornaments from the pearls and rubies. And also we are told from our Sikh Imam Jaffari Sadiq alayhi salam, Muhammad ibn Ali Muhammad, that you know that Kawthar is a stream in heaven. This is what Imam Jaffari Sadiq alayhi salam says, that the Kawthar is a stream in the heaven, in heaven, that Allah has granted his apostle for his son who died in his lifetime. You know that you know Rasulullah did not have sons. When he had sons, you know, they died in you know infancy. And the last son that he had was Hazrat Qasim, and he also, you know, died. So, you know, the kuffar were taunting him that his abtar, jama puchna hoy, puchri na hoy, okay? He's, you know, abtar. So we are told from a Sikh Imam al-Islam that Kawthar is a stream in the heaven that Allah has granted his Rasul for his son who died in his lifetime. So this son who died in his lifetime was you know, Hazrat Qasim. Okay, so you know, sources also you know, tell us, you know, that the purpose of using the word Kawthar is for the pool of abundance, you know, Hawzal Kawthar. Also we are told that inshallah, all of us, inshallah wa ta'ala, that we will be granted when we go to the Jannat, inshallah, all of us, there's a pool there, you know, Al-Kawthar. That is the pool as well, which is referred to. So sources also tell us the pool purpose of using the word Kawthar is for the pool of abundance, Hawzal Kawthar. It is Hawz, it is big pool of water. It's called Hawz Al-Kawthar, that belongs to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from where the believers will quench their thirst when arriving in Jannat. And we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us, all of us, inshallah wa ta'ala, the tawfiq, inshallah, to be in that company, inshallah, all of us, inshallah. Can we have one salawat, please? Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. So, sources also, you know, tell us that the purpose of using the word Kawthar is for the pool of abundance, how the Kawthar, that belongs to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from where the believers will quench their thirst when they arrive in Jannat. And of course, we pray to Allah that inshallah, all of us, you know, to be, you know, part of that. Mufassirin also give, you know, several examples of abundance. So what does he mean by Kawthar? Inna atainaka al-kawthar. Kawthar means abundance. So Mufassirin also give us several examples of this Kawthar, meaning abundance of every good. Anything that is good, it will be in abundance and much more to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, fulfilling the true meaning of this particular ayat. So you know, when we study the seerah of Rasulullah, this was a clear prophecy that was totally fulfilled, showing clearly the truthfulness and the miracle of the Quran. Because this prophecy is given in the Quran, was it going to be real? And all the prophecies that we see in the Quran, I've given a talk actually once, you know, three kinds of prophecies. Prophecies that were fulfilled in the time of Rasulullah, prophecies that were fulfilled after the passing of Rasulullah, and there are prophecies that are being fulfilled and will be fulfilled after the passing of Rasulullah until before the day of Qiyamah. We'll see the third kind of prophecy will also be fulfilled. So, you know, alhamdulillah, then we are collectively trying to ponder all this surah in this month of Ramadan, and are seeking the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the dua for the tawfiq in understanding the great implications of this surah. So, you know, so then this particular surah, ayat, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, inna atainaka al-kawthar, which we have already dealt with, then the second ayat, fasalli li rabbika wanhar, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling Rasulullah to offer, you know, the prayers to your Rabb and offer your sacrifice. No, so fasalli li rabbika, offer salat to your Rabb. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from whose blessings descend, and it is to him that the salat is offered. He is the Rabb, He is the Cherisher, the Nourisher, the Provider, and for all other blessings. So the Quraysh, on the contrary, were worshipping and prostrating to the idols instead of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, you know, in this particular surah, then Surah Al-Kawthar, Wanhar, and offer your sacrifice, or some Mufassirin are actually telling us that the sacrifice mentioned here refers to the offering of the Salat, where the neck is pointing towards the Qibla. So when, you know, when the animal is being sacrificed, you know, I've seen that, you know, myself, you know, when we went, you know, for Hajj and all that, so, you know, when this, you know, sacrifice is given, you know, the person who's sacrificing makes sure that he is, you know, pushing him, you know, putting his face, you know, face in the Qibla. So most Mufassirin have said that it means, you know, offering animal sacrifice together with Salat, showing complete devotion and submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, the commentary on Majmal Bayan, I don't know what the time is, I've got under a few minutes, under 2 minutes or so. So commentary on Majmal Bayan points to the true traditions with Jibreel tells Rasulullah that Allah has commanded, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends Jibreel to give the message to Rasulullah. So here Jibreel, who comes to Rasulullah and says to him that Allah has commanded you to raise your hands at the beginning of the prayer when you say Allahu Akbar, and you are going to perform bowing of prostrations, and after that, because our prayer and that of the angels in the seven heavens are like this, everything has an adornment, and the adornment of prayer is raising hands at the time of saying Allahu Akbar. Can we want salawat, please? Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa Muhammad. Similarly, on our sixth Imam Jafar Sadiq alayhi salam, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad, has said that, you know, that the purpose is that when you raise your hands so that your palms be towards the Qibla. Okay, so the purpose is, you know, so the raising in hands, our head, when we say Allahu Akbar, Imam Jafar Sadiq alayhi salam, the purpose of doing this is that you raise your hands so that your palms are towards the Qibla. So when I'm standing here at the Qibla, when I raise my hands, this Allahu Akbar, my palms are facing the Qibla. So, you know, that's what Imam Jafar Sadiq alayhi salam has said. And then the third ayat, Inna Shaniyaka wal Abdur. So, wal Asr, Inna Linsan of Khud illa, I'm just so sorry. Inna Shaniyaka wal Abdur. This is the third ayat. The final ayat, Inna Atainaka Kawthar Fasalli Rabbika Wanhar, Inna Shaniyaka Wal Abtar. This is the last ayat of this surah, Surah Al-Kawthar. So, you know, if we understand then a couple of words in this ayat, it will be simple to understand this ayat quite easily. Inna Shaniyaka, I mean, surely, without any doubt, the one who hates you, the word Shana, Shani, and it derives meaning to hate or to loathe. So the word inna means without, definitely inna shaniyaka, those who hate you, those who are your enemies are the one who you loathe. So they are the ones who are actually going to be cut off. Well, abdur, they shall be the one who will be cut off. So the word abdur originally means the animal whose tail is cut off. And the enemies of Islam were taunting Rasulullah by calling him Abtar. Who Abtar? Why? Because Rasulullah did not have any sons. Okay, so they were calling him Abtar, meaning that, you know, he had no sons who would inherit his position. In the shining equal Abtar, I've got another 30 seconds. So we were hoping Islam will not survive after Rasulullah. But this ayat is therefore then a clear prophecy that in fact it is Islam that it always survive, and the real after will be the enemy who will be forgotten, whereas Islam will not only survive but will always thrive. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept this from us. Can we have one loud salawat, please? Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ali Muhammad. Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin, Allah بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آله